All of us get involved in communication on daily basis. We are human beings. We have this, you know, virtue of tongue and especially speech. Only we can communicate through speech. We have so many, you know, other entities here. Non-human entities exist in this world. They breathe, but they do not have the power of speech. We are the only creature who has received this gift of speech. So when we say communication, this is nothing new. All of you know what is communication. If I ask you to define it, will you be able to do that? Anyone would like to tell me what is communication? Anyone, please raise your hands. Whenever you want to talk, please raise your hand. Do not start speaking by unmuting yourself. That create a kind of chaos here. Yes, Bharat.
Ma'am, we communicate when we talk to someone or express our thoughts and understand their thoughts.
Very good, very good. Divyanshu?
Communication means interaction and expression of our feelings and also listening to the feelings and the thoughts of someone else.
Very good. Goja Sri Maurya.
It is a mutual interaction with a certain set of protocols.
Certain set of protocols. What do you mean by in these set of protocols?
It is a certain set of rules and regulation. Like we cannot talk to an individual like in whatever way we want.
Mm-hmm. So that is communication in special scenarios or communication in general? I mean general. Goja, what is your first name here? You will have to help me here. What is your first name here?
The same thing you have spoken, ma'am.
Okay, Goja is your first name. Okay, that's it means I was right. So what do you mean by this? Is it general communication or is it a special communication? Because right now we are communicating with each other, but we are bound by protocols. We have to follow protocols. You took permission and then only you could share. This is what you meant. Right?
Yes, ma'am. That is what I meant exactly.
So, I'm asking about communication in general. Do you people have anything to add to what these other people have said? Ishita, Amisha? If you have anything to add there, I'll take your opinion. Otherwise, let's start with the slides.
Ma'am, I had a minor doubt.
Yeah, yes, Ishita.
Ma'am, like you said that we have been gifted with the virtue of speech. So ma'am, like we consider this to be the speech, whatever we are speaking, in the same way the other animals might be considering their way of communication to be the actual speech, and they must be considering our way of communication to be some other like ways.
Yes, why not, Ishita? That is a very interesting perspective there, very interesting take. But if I ask you, I think you are a cat person. There is a cat on your profile picture as well.
No, ma'am, it's just because I like the picture.
Okay, so how many times have you seen animals gathering together and talking to each other?
Ma'am, many times I see dogs every time in my colony.
When they have to bark with each other, that is the only time I think they collect with each other.
We think that they are barking and they are fighting or something like that. But it might be possible that it's their way of communication and it's their speech.
No, I'm not saying that they cannot talk or they cannot, you know, speech is a set of rules. Okay, when we are talking, we have been taught how to communicate with each other. Do you really think that people, like this is English in which we are talking right now, we all have our mother tongues. Okay, even there, when we were kids, our parents took time, they gave inputs, they put, you know, lot of efforts there, and then we learned how to communicate. Okay, so by speech, I mean that sounds are made by everyone. Okay. I'm not refuting it, because there are several studies, there are several people who are working on this. And if you watch those National Geographic, Geography channel or other channels like Discovery, you will find there are several cases where they find that, yes, they make certain calls, you know, when they are in danger and other animals of their species come and help them. Okay. In general also, you know, our world is full of the sounds, you know, it's full of sounds made by other creatures. We listen to cows, dogs, and, you know, other animals, even birds chirp throughout the day. So I'm not refuting this claim that they do not have sound, but we cannot understand that. There are very few people who can talk to other entities. Okay?
Yes, ma'am. Okay, ma'am.
I'm not saying that they cannot produce sound, but that can that be can we call that speech? That is the biggest question.
Ma'am, I mean to say that it's not speech from our perspective, but from their perspective, what they are communicating is a speech, and what we are speaking is like for them, our language is some kind of ununderstandable language, and. Their language must be a speech for them. Something there like ants, the colony of ants.
So
they have a whole system.
Yeah. Again, I'm saying they all have their own systems. That is again a parallel world there, you know. Forest and in jungles, they have their own societies, the way they live. But again, we are unable to understand that. And I highly doubt that that can be studied as a, you know, as a language there, or how many out of us can understand that. When I said speech, you can also say that we have the, again, they have brains. We have brains, they also have brains. But ours is most developed one. We can, you know, make houses, we can create things, we plan things, we, you know, we execute those plans, but this is not possible for those. So yes, they make sounds there and they understand each other. But when it comes to language or speech, I think we are the most developed one.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you.
Okay. Amisha, do you have something to add here?
Ma'am, I like just wanted to say that communication is kind of a very essential skill, which enables us to express our thoughts and emotions, either verbally or non-verbally, which kind of includes even written stuff. And like, it's a two-way process where the listener is as important as the speaker. That's all.
Very good. That is, you know, that explains almost everything. You have included all the things. So let's look into this definition, the formal definition of communication. So this is given by Kate Davis. He was an expert in communication. So he has given it here. Communication is the transfer of information and understanding from one person to another person. It is a way of reaching others with facts, ideas, thoughts, and values. Okay, so what you people have told me so far, it includes all the points that yes, we have information to share. And when we share it with the other person, we have to take care of the, you know, ideas of that person as well. So in a way, we can say they are a speaker and they are a listener. And then again, in the proper way, we generally call them, you know, in technical way, we call them sender and receiver. Two parties which are involved in any communication, they are called sender and receiver. There is a role reversal to run this cycle of or this process of communication to keep it going. They keep changing their roles, and this communication process is completed with the help of that. So here we have to focus on mainly on this thing that communication is something where we are transferring our ideas, thoughts, any fact we have, whatever values we hold, we share it with the other party. And here the most important thing is that the other person should understand these thoughts in the same perspective as was intended by the sender. Okay, if I am the sender right now and you are the receiver, and when I explain something to you, it's my duty to find out whether you received it in the same perspective or not. Like just few minutes ago, we had a conversation here with Ishita. I had this conversation because she had few problems, and I wanted to make it sure that what my intention was, it should be clear to her. So that's why we had that conversation. In the same manner, this communication is a very, very general term, especially with the advent of, you know, this corporate culture. This has become very, very important as well. Especially, we generally listen to people that if you want to be successful in your life, your communication should be very good. Or please improve your communication skills. Without that, you cannot survive. So here in this particular course, we are going to learn how to improve our communication. Okay. This term communication has been derived from a Latin word. The Latin word is communicare. What does this mean? To share. Okay. Communicare means share in Latin, and the same way it has originated from there. So here in English also, we mean by communication to share or to transmit something. Okay, so especially when we transmit information or any data, fact, any thoughts, then it becomes communication from one person to another person. Is it clear? Do you now understand what is communication? Although you had an idea earlier.
Yes, ma'am.
So now we move to the next one, which is technical communication. Now we'll try to find out what is technical communication. So before moving to this, I would like to know, what do you mean by technical? All of you are studying this technical subject here. You are students of technical education, future technocrats. So what do you mean by technology? Sorry, technical, not technology. What do you mean by technical? Please raise your hands. You can guess it. I'm not asking for the accurate answer. Yes, Divyanshu.
I'm technical as it sounds, as we speak it. So it means like it's relating to some technique.
Technique, yes, very good.
A particular technique.
So what do we mean by technique? Any idea?
Technique means a specific way of doing things.
Very good. Very good, Divyanshu. Yes, Aditi, do you have anything to add here?
Maybe formal conversation type of thing.
Technical means formal. That is part of, you know, technical, but that cannot be summarized as technical. That is part of technical. Something formal. Anyone else would like to tell me what technical means?
Ma'am, expertise, ma'am, means someone expert in that field who said that he is technical.
Yes, technical means you have this specific knowledge, okay, about that particular trade or field. If you possess that knowledge only, then you can deal with the technique of that particular trade or business. Let's look into this properly. The word technical has been described by Oxford Advanced Learner Dictionary as connected with the practical use of machinery and methods in science and industry. So when, you know, who was this? Divyanshu. When Divyanshu said that there is a technique, by technical we means technique, it means methods. There are certain methods in which you execute something. And when it is especially related to science and industry, this becomes our technical communication. Okay, so let's read the definition here of technical communication. Technical communication therefore means the transmission of facts, figures, idea, and all sorts of scientific and technical information from one individual to another. Here you can see that the whole definition is similar to the one we just studied. Facts, figures, ideas are being transmitted from one individual to another, but they are focused on scientific and technical information. Okay, so when they are focused on scientific and technical communication information, they become technical communication. Anyone has any idea what are the, you know, what are the documents or what are the examples of this technical communication? Anyone? Please make it more interactive, otherwise you will get bored. Okay, if you do not talk with me or do not, you know, contribute here, it will be very, very difficult for us.
Ma'am, social media, we can.
Social media is technical communication. It is rather more from, you know, general communication. Yes, Ria.
Ma'am, communication, ma'am, thesis paper, researchers paper, yeah, in communication in written form, we can say that to it. Or मतलब ये जो lectures होते हैं इनको भी बोल सकते हैं एक तरीके से technical communication जो professors देते हैं शायद.
Yes, yeah, you can communicate in English. I could see that, you know. So please stick to English. We are studying communication here. It will be better if you speak in English.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, okay, no problem. Dhanraj.
Ma'am, in office works and other important works, we used to communicate within using this communication.
Very good. Sarfaraz.
Yes. Ma'am, if we share a theorem or formula of science and mathematics, then this is a technical communication.
Very good. Very good. That can also fall into the category of technical communication. Yes, so others have already spoken, so please lower down your hands. Yes, Naman, would you like to add something here?
I was just saying, like, in any professional kind of work, professional
scenario,
like he told, whatever. In offices and all.
Yes, right, that is right. Okay, so let me give you the examples properly. When you go to corporate, or whenever you know, even if you go for startups, if you decide to be entrepreneur, anywhere, when you are, involved in official scenario, you have to produce certain documents there. Okay, let it be a report, a project report can be there, that there can be a proposal for a new, you know, project. And then you, on daily basis, you write several emails when you are in a, you know, job. These things, when they have something specific, the idea or the, you know, reason behind this communication is specific, and we give those details there, they become technical communication. So here we can very easily include those, science related stuff. As you said, that formulas are there, theorems are there. When you go for conferences, when you go for seminars, where experts have gathered together to listen to your papers, in that information becomes your technical communication, because you are elaborating about a particular field, okay, or about a particular topic where the other experts are, you know, they are also concerned with that. So all these people have gathered there for that specific information. So that becomes technical communication again, okay. Can you people give me an example of, you know, a very popular example is there. Let me give you this example, because I don't think you will be able to guess what I am thinking. Whenever you buy any new machine, any new gadget, you receive a kind of user manual with that. Do you think that is technical communication?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. So who has written that? Who writes those user manuals?
Manufacturer?
No, not the manufacturer. Most of the times the engineers who. Yes, Rahul, what would you like to add here?
Yes, ma'am. Rahul? I was saying.
Yeah, you were saying the same thing?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. You know, there is a term called content writer. Content writers or, you know, technical writers, when you will go and work as a, you know, engineer, you will find out that they hire, when you are the project leader or you have the whole project up to you. So there are people hire these technical writers or content writers, and with the help of them, they create these user manuals and other documents. But as an engineer, this is your responsibility to understand how to do that, because that particular gadget has been, you know, I'm not talking about only software engineers, because you people are more concerned with coding and all, but other kind of engineers are also there. So here, when we talk about user manuals, that is just an example. It is not restricted to that. I'm giving you so that you can have an idea. We all are the end users. Okay, whenever we buy something, we are the end users. And to make us, you know, comfortable in using those gadgets, they put those small booklets there so that we can understand. We get the pictures there. All the parts are labeled, how to use that, how to replace the, you know, parts if something stops working. All these things. So that is the you know, most popular example of technical communication. And these are very, very difficult, you know, when we talk about project reports. And, these are not restricted to written documents only. Oral communication is also a part of it. When you are in a job, you are supposed to take part in meetings on daily basis, where you have to share your thoughts with your, you know, superiors. And at the same time, you are supposed to give project reports, you have to give presentations, there are group discussions. In all these areas, you are not indulging in any written communication, but that is also technical, because again, the audience is specific. It's not like you are working in an office and then you go out and start talking about your work with anyone. Those who are related to it, those who are concerned with it, only they will understand, and only with them you are going to share your ideas. Okay, so whenever we are talking about any machinery, any method which is related to science and industry, it becomes our technical communication. Clear? Shall we move to the next slide?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Now we come to importance of technical communication. Before moving into these words which I have written here, I would like to give you a brief history of this technical communication, how this one originated. You know, communication is part of our society from ages. Even early men had their own way of talking. We have developed with evolution, we have learned so many things, so our language also evolved, and it is a very developed one right now. If you happen to read those poems or works written by authors in 13th and 14th century, have you ever read any poem of that era? You must have read it from Shakespeare, Dau, Dai, those kind of words. Are you familiar with them? So now they are obsolete. We don't use them. If you use them, most of the time it is for entertainment sake, or we are having any, you know, specialized study there. That's why we use. We do not use Dao and Dai in our daily conversation or even in written communication. So communication is very, very old, and with the passage of time, we have developed ourselves very much. I was saying that if you go through how they used to teach in write in 13th or 14th century, you will find out small words were written in so many letters. You know, for night they used to write NIGHTE, and they had very long spellings for small works. From there, they have, you know, chopped off those useless pieces, and now we have smaller words. And with the fashion or the kind of lingo we use on social media these days, they are getting even shorter. We don't write HAVE, we write HAVE. We do not write NIGHT, we write NIT only. Okay, so what are we doing? We are making them even shorter. So main thing here is that communication is very old. It keeps, you know, it keeps developing. And this is why we say that language learning is a very dynamic process. You cannot say I have learned the language. On daily basis, new words are included, and on daily basis, we learn them, we start using them. Okay. So how did this technical communication started? That is the question here. In, 17th century, early 17th century, we know that Britishers were the invaders, you know, they used to attack different countries. They used to win them over and their rule was established there. And if they were not attacking those countries, they were having trade there. Okay, that was also one of the plan how they expanded their region or their rule all over the world. So when they were in this trade or in business with other countries, they needed documents. There was a need of documentation. And with the need of that, this particular documentation started. Especially in 1660, there was this Royal Society, the foundation of They starting they started having those experimentation, scientific experimentation. And with the advent of that, this formats culture, there should be a proper format for everything. You know, when you study science in your schools, even, you know, you people are in just first year. So you could see that while you were studying history or geography, there was no set format how to write anything. But when you were in a lab, when you were, you know, carrying out any experiment, you were supposed to submit the report in the proper format. Okay, so this documentation, this formatting of the documents started with this Royal Society, and from there it has, you know, developed itself in many forms. Today, if you are supposed to submit a daily report, you have a different format. If you are supposed to submit this weekly report, you have different. For annual report, it is different. We have formats for all of that, and we find it very easy to fill them. If I give you a plain paper and ask you to report what you did in your day, it will be difficult for you. It will take time. But if I give you a format where you have to fill in the data only, you find it very easy to fill. Okay, so with the help of this, it was easier for them to document their, for documentation, it was very, very helpful. And this is where technical communication exactly started. And then we have, invention of computers. With the invention of computer and its uses, everything has become so, technical these days. All over the world, we are sitting in one place and we can communicate with other people. And it's very easy for us, with the help of computers to produce technical communication. And why it is important today, if I focus on these three terms, it can give us the overview why this technical communication is so important. The new buzzwords for the corporate world are globalization, intercultural teams, and technology. Okay, so these are the challenges as well, and these are they facilitate our communication on daily basis. So who would like to give me an idea about globalization? What do you understand by globalization? Anyone, please raise your hand. Okay, these are new students. Garima Yadav.
Ma'am, in short, we can say globalization is the independence of trades of goods and services across the border.
Very good. Very good, Garima. Siddhant?
Ma'am, it is interdependence of nations for various services, for trade and jobs.
Very good. Very good. You understand this. Okay, Neha, would you like to tell us about intercultural teams? Neha?
Ma'am, I don't have much of an idea about intercultural teams, ma'am, but I can guess it. I just hope it means communication between different cultures or, exchange of different cultures between, people.
Yeah. Good effort there. Divyanshu?
Like intercultural teams are a result of globalization only, because we are globalizing, so people along the whole globe, different languages are shared. So if they are getting it one place, they are going to other place for the job, so they require that they have proper communication from people from various parts.
Thank you, Divyanshu. You have included everything. Aditi, would you like to tell us how technology is important?
Ma'am, technologically basically is applications of the
scientific knowledge that we get?
That is technical. I'm asking about technology.
Oh, technology. Technology is like the various inventions that we can apply in day-to-day life.
Yes. Oh, thank you. Thank you. Now let me explain it to you why these three terms are so, so important. By globalization, we mean, you know, the way the boundaries are being removed these days. We are in different regions, we are living in different countries, but with this globalization, this world has become a global village. We feel like we can reach any person anytime, okay? And that is possible because of technology. With the help of mobile phones, with the help of internet, emailing, faxing, these things have made it very easy to contact anyone all over the world. It is very popular. Most of us have relatives who are living in different countries now. So somehow, and even if not relatives, friends, or, you know, if you are on social media, we connect with different experts as well out there. And we can see that with the help of this globalization and with the help of technology, the communication has become very, very easy. And it is very important to learn it, because without learning this, we cannot survive in today's corporate world. Okay. Why do we say so? Like right now, you people are very young. It is very easy for you people to learn about technology. But when it comes to teachers, you know, not everyone is tech savvy. Not everyone understands computers. Earlier, it was about blackboard and chalk. Okay, we had our books, we had our blackboard and chalk, and it was enough for us. But right now, if we want to communicate with you, we will have to learn so many things. We have learned so many things in past few months, just because we wanted it to run smoothly here. So this is why, if you want to survive in corporate world, it is very, very important to learn how to use technology. And with the help of that, we can do anything, you know. And when we talk about intercultural, it is intercultural. You know, we are living in India, and within India, we speak so many languages. And even then, we are sitting together here and communicating with each other. So how does it happen? Okay, because we have found out certain unique features are here involved, and we can say that we have made provisions so that we can pull out this one particular thing. Why do you think it is very easy for us to right now communicate with each other? What is that one thing which is unifying us right now? You people are from different parts of the country. That is true. Is that true?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. And if there is any student who is from the, you know, other country as well, is there anyone who is sitting in any other country, not in India? Please raise your hand if we have any here, because in other classes we have DASA students. Okay, no problem. Even within India, it's not possible to, you know, communicate with each other without that one thing. What is that? Who will tell us?
Ma'am, we all know English.
Because of English. So because of English, we can do it very, very easily. So this English, it doesn't work in India only. This works on international level. And what is happening these days, you know, people migrate to other places. When you join a job, they ask you whether you will be able to go overseas or not. Are you willing to relocate if your project demands that? And there are several people who are working in another country with people of different cultures. What do you mean by culture? Any idea? We use this term very frequently these days, intercultural. So inter means from different. What is culture?
Culture is the daily to daily basis habits. We can also term it as culture, and everything, including our religious practices and the daily habits.
Yes, very good. Very good, Rajdeep. We call them attributes or values. Okay, so when we share these values with other people, that particular area or that particular group will be called culture. Okay, culture is shared set of beliefs and attributes. So when people from different set of people who possess different set of beliefs and attributes, when they start working under the same roof, it becomes very difficult. But with the help of technology and this globalization, it runs very smoothly. But we have to work very hard to achieve that particular stage. And this is why we learn technical communication. In the next unit, we have barriers to communication, where this cultural communication is a special unit or say topic. We will look into that in the next unit. And you will understand why people fail to communicate when cultures are different and how we can overcome that. Okay, so this is why technical communication is very important. Learning it is very important. So I guess this one is clear.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Oh,
okay.
So now we come to the features of technical communications, especially technical writing. Technical communication means your presentation and group discussion meetings, they are also part of our oral communication. So that we will deal in the later unit, or when we will come to oral communication and written communication in detail. Here we are talking about only on general level or on the initial level, what is technical writing. Okay, so when you write a report, especially a report, if you keep that in your mind that you are writing a report, what are the things you are going to keep in mind? First of all, use of familiar and easy words. Okay, why do we say that? Because up till now, you people have studied so many subjects. When even in your previous semester, you were studying ELC, I guess.
Yes, ma'am.
Was there any poetry involved? There were poems, I guess.
Yes, ma'am.
And there were essays as well.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So you can see that when you read a scientific report, the language is very different. And when you read those poems, the language is very, very different. Did you find this? Even in essays, if you take the same syllabus of ELC, you will find out that the language of poetry was very different from the language of essays. So the basic thing is, when we write poetry, we do not follow the typical rules of grammar. We are mostly sentimental there. The language is very flowery. Figures of speeches are used. And we do not do here in the technical communication, technical writing. There are so many figures of speech there. People use them to give weightage to their sentences, so that when someone reads, they get impressed. We are not trying to do that here. The basic of technical writing is there is a need to communicate that particular data which you have collected. It can be fact, it can be idea, it can be a decision. So you are supposed to write that in a familiar and simple, easy words, so that the reader can understand them very well. Second is use of clear sentences. We do not write very lengthy and complex sentences. The style of writing should be something, or the style of writing should be so that the sentences are very clear and it can be understood by everyone. Okay. Third is sentences of moderate length. There is no direction, there is no set rule that only these many words can be included in a sentence. But generally, where 12 to 25 words are used in a sentence, that is called the moderate length. And we should not try to write, there are people who start writing a sentence and after fifth or sixth sentence, they put the full stop. That kind of writing should not be there. We should write sentences where all the important information is included in that sentence, but it is not very lengthy. I guess you people have studied how to write paragraphs.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes,
ma'am. So yes, people ma'am. Who, every paragraph has a topic sentence and other sentences support that.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, the same thing is here as well. When you are composing something, when you are writing something, you should write sentences of moderate length. Use of active voice. What is the difference between active and passive voice? where is the focus in active voice?
Ma'am, the focus is typically on the person who is performing the action.
Yes, very good. We call them subject or the doer. If I say I wrote the report, so the focus is on I wrote the report. I'm taking the responsibility. And when it is the report has been written by me, here the focus is on the report. So in technical communication, when we are writing something, we write it in active voice. The doer should be included properly. Okay. But when we are, you know, giving instructions, generally, what do we see? They write it in passive voice. Have you read those signs? This is the example I'm giving in all the classes. Trespassers will be prosecuted. Have you read this sign anywhere? Trespassers will be prosecuted.
Yes, ma'am. On the boards.
On the boards. Who is going to prosecute you there? Or the trespasser?
Policeman or the official who is surrounding
So they do not include their name. It is obvious there that the authorities are going to prosecute you. The main focus there is on the action. If you try to trespass that particular area, you will be prosecuted. So the focus, where the focus is, according to that we construct our sentence. So here in technical writing, it is mostly it is written in active voice only. Okay. And then we have avoid redundant phrases. What do we mean by redundancy? Any idea?
Unnecessary or excessive.
Very good, Amisha. When we, you know, have words which are not necessarily needed there. Okay. Like we generally say revert back. Please, I have sent you this message. Please revert back, accept. So what do we mean by revert in general? Any idea? What is revert?
Something like returning back.
Something returning back. That is right. Return back. Revert means return back or reply back. So back is already written here. But mostly it is written revert back. So that is redundancy. We are using excessive words there which are not needed. In the same manner, we have, you know, if you have alternative choices. Choices means alternative and alternatives means choices. So we are not supposed to use them together. In the same manner, final results. Results are final. We do not write final results. Okay, so whenever we are composing any piece of writing or when we are writing something, especially for technical purposes, we should try to reduce or avoid these redundant phrases. Then again, we have, you know, inaccurate expressions. They are expressions which are ambiguous. Okay, they lead to one or two meanings. So we should try to remove those expressions from our writing. If you use those kind of words which are open to two or three meanings, your message can be understood in any other perspective. While we have discussed it, it should be in the same perspective as is intended by the sender. So please do not use those kind of words, you know, dangling phrases are there. Certain times we are unable to understand in a sentence, his is used for whom. Okay, so that kind of sentences should not be constructed. And finally, we have logical division of paragraphs. What do we mean by this? All of you must have, you know, seen those, as someone was saying, social media. Even if you are on Facebook or LinkedIn or even WhatsApp, we receive those forwards. They start and there are no gaps. They do not divide them in any paragraph. And you keep scrolling and they are so lengthy that finally you just scroll past them and send the message to the other person that it is good. So the same thing happens when you write a report where you do not divide them in proper paragraphs. There are people who write things in block format, you know, from first line to the last line, whole page is filled. So do you feel motivated to read these kind of writings when you get something written from the first line to the last line? Do you feel like reading them?
No.
So as you know how to write paragraphs, find out the main idea according to that, you know, inductive, deductive, whatever order you are following there. Generally, writing is divided into three paragraphs: introduction, middle, and then conclusion. So try to, you know, divide your paragraphs according to that. And if you are writing them logically, you know, in a way where reader can understand where you are taking that particular writing, that is good. That should how we should write technical pieces. Okay. I think we should stop here, because this general and technical communication will take time, and we don't have that much time today. Up till now, if you have any query, please ask. Okay, I guess you people have no problems. And if you have any, please note them down. You can ask them to me on next Friday. You can ask them to sir as well, but it will be better if you come to me, because he might be confused because this was taken by me. So note them down and you can ask me those things in the next lecture. Shall we end it here? Shall we call it a day?
Yes, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you for listening.
Thank you, ma'am.
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 Thank you, ma'am. Good evening.
Thank you, ma'am.